actors, stars, superstars. We're all heroes till the arc lights go off. But there are others, ordinary people who lead extraordinary lives, simple people who don't need to be in front of the camera or don't need to be under a spotlight to be heroic. Life itself is a stage for them. It's the incredible stories of these people that you'll be watching in the next half hour. I'm Vikram, and I'll be bringing you six amazing stories of six real heroes from South India. Otto Raja used to spend his days crouching on the streets, and perhaps that's the reason he's now rescuing destitutes from those very same streets and giving them food, clothing, and a roof above their head, but most important, dignity. His home of hope is testimony enough to his dedication.
In 1983, T. Raja was just a wastrel on the streets of Chennai.
I was with some hopeless friends. Daytime we'll drink and nighttime we'll go to movies. And drugs and ganja, arak and all we used to drink. My whole family, they used to curse me. They told me if he die, it's good for him. Then they chased me out from home.
And Raja was just 15 when he was thrown into jail for squatting on public land.
Chennai, they put me in a jail and for 30 days. And my whole life was like that. I jumped into a spiritual world and I used to pray much. I used to spend time. I used to go to church many times. And then I started to live really bad habits, drinking and robbing things and stealing this. Everything has stopped and drinking, everything stopped. And I drive auto rickshaw and a car and for that reason they will call me Auto Raja.
Raja borrowed 1,000 rupees from his parents and learned to drive. At 23, when he got married, he was already the auto rickshaw driver's union head. But as he drove through the city, images from his past returned to haunt him.
Just to see the people are lying in the road, then I can understand what is the street life I know. Then I used to see the people are struggling in the road and in the dying condition. 6 months, 4 months, they won't take bath, and like a dog they will sleep. And I used to see this kind of people are struggling in the street, and I used to pray, God, see, this kind of people are dying. Who will care these people? Even Mother Teresa, she also died. Then who will care this? Then can I do this?
Raja started rescuing the homeless but had no place to go. So he took them home, much to the dismay of his family. With some initial donations from friends, he took a home on rent and started his home with 13 destitutes. It's only in the late 1990s when the Christ organization donated half an acre land that Raja's home of hope became a reality. Since then, Raja has rescued close to 3,000 homeless people, and those who died in the home were given dignity in death.
One man I took in near one coal street. They are he's in a last stage. I took him in a van. I rushed to the hospital. Please help me, save him. I will after save and give me unto death. I will feed him. Please help me, doctor. I told the doctor told he's very smell. Please you clean and bring it. Then I took him my home and I started to give bath. After giving bath, he died.
It's now been 14 years, but Raja is still completely hands-on in serving the destitute. From cutting their nails to cleaning their wounds. And his reward lies quite simply in these smiles.